Everyone, they're now Nike become a $1 billion company. Hi, my name is Beast, and I decided to be my captain on Nike. I always wonder how Nike evolved over time and what has made it so successful. Nike was founded in 1964 by running coach Bill Bowden and middle distance runner Phil Knight. One day, Phil Knight had a crazy idea to start a shoe company. He went to Japan to find some shoes to sell in America. He got some shoes from a super tight. Now, that brand is known as Asics. First known as Blue Ribbon Sports, and in 1971, college student Caroline Davidson designed a famous swoosh for only a very low price of $35. Phil Knight decided to change the name to Nike based on the goddess of victory. Can you believe that in 1 year, Nike went from $1,000 to $8,000? That's really good for a brand new company. Now you ask, what makes Nike so popular? Is it their pricing? Well, Nike's pricing is not that fair. For an unknown shoe brand running shoe, it would be around $40. The same quality shoe at Nike would be around $60. Now you ask, why pay those prices? So many people have trusted Nike over the years that they don't want to risk the quality and buy another brand's shoe. This is the reason people just buy Nike, and Nike has captured the hearts of so many customers. Another area where Nike can become popular is the equipment quality. This is an area where Nike dominates. Nike has released a shoe called the Paper Max, which has air sockets on the bottom of the shoe. This is a new way of cushioning, and it's really been extremely successful. On some types of shoes, Nike has a light mode, a regular mode, and a tough mode. The light mode is a shoe that does not have too much cushioning, but it's really light, meaning that it's really good for people who want to compete and become a better runner. The regular shoe is just a regular shoe you have to find. The regular shoe you would find has decent cushioning but decent weight. Those are the shoes I'm probably currently wearing. Another shoe is the tough mode. The tough mode has a lot of cushioning but it's quite heavy. This shoe is more known for regular day and to keep you comfortable. Based on your own personal preference, Nike can make you feel like this. The last way Nike can become popular is shoe deals with famous athletes. Look at this. This is the 2018 NBA All-Stars. These are the best 24 players in the NBA. Out of these 24 players, 6 of them have shoe deals with Nike. In my opinion, that is quite crazy because 1/4 of these players all shoe deals with Nike. I think the next one that comes closest is Adidas with about 3 players. This just shows the Nike dominates the footwear aspect. Look at this. This is the Nike current sales by division. Out of Nike's all money made, more than 58% of it comes from footwear. Now you ask, finally, what keeps Nike at that number one spot? Well, it's reinvesting. For example, a long time ago, Nike took a gamble and signed rookie Michael Jordan to a shoe deal. That shoe deal ended up making millions of dollars. They used that money to sign LeBron James, Kobe Bryant, Kyrie Irving, and more. On the other hand, Under Armour made a lot of money for the Curry shoe. Instead of using that money to get another superstar, they decided to use that money to buy mansions, build Rolexes, and much more like luxury stuff. Another way Nike is becoming too popular is new technology. As I said before, the Vapor Max has a new type of cushioning, which is really successful. This is the Nike Mat. The Nike Mat was the first self-lacing shoe that is very popular but very expensive. This shoe has only 86 created in existence. This shoe was about, I think, $300,000 in retail price because it's new technology and extremely comfortable. For more information, visit my blog. Thank you so much for listening to my presentation.